As promised, Ross is now the second most significant former Buffalo Bill in this segment. Joining us on the phone, Hall of Fame quarterback Jim Kelly. Jim, thanks for being with us. And before we talk some football, when your name comes up, I think I have the reaction a lot of people have around the country. First of all, I'd like to hear how you're feeling.
I'm doing pretty good. I can't really complain. And it's interesting how the more I travel, the more people I talk to, the more speaking engagements I do, I realize that I'm a blessed man, that there's so many people that have a lot worse than I do. You know, and I feel pretty good. Got things coming up in the next couple weeks in New York City. But other than that, great Christmas and looking forward to a great new year.
Good to hear.
Yeah, that's awesome to hear, Jim. And we're in New York City right now, but I'll be in Buffalo on Sunday calling that Jets-Bills game. Obviously a big one for the Jets. I'm curious, Jim, how you feel right now about Rex Ryan. I know there was a lot of excitement when Rex got hired. Do you feel like the excitement's still there for you personally?
Yeah, but of course, I think just like most people, when you have that much hype before the season, you know, all the talking that Rex did, all the talking that I did, all the talking that everybody did, you look at it and to really, you know, pan it all down and come to the end of the season, we did make the playoffs, and I think that's totally a big disappointment, not only for me, but for Rex, too. And I still think Rex is a good coach. I think that it's going to take a little time, and, I mean, that's what we all pray for and hope for, especially offensively. But defensively, to be honest with you, that probably more than anything was the biggest disappointment in my eyes. I don't know what the whole situation is. I have so many more things going on in my life, from my son's foundation to my kids to really doing the things that I want to do after I retire, to really know deep down what the problems were, what the issues were. And I do understand. I think you guys know, especially Ross, that injuries do definitely play a big part in it. It does. I mean, but still, you have your big quality players, Mario Williams and people like that. I think early on the season, even midway through, I think a lot of people not playing real smart football, the disciplinary reasons from, you know, not sticking to your assignment, trying to be more of an individual than going out there and doing what you're supposed to do and stupid penalties. But I think we gotten better as the year wound down, but unfortunately it's a little too late.
Jim, in quarterback Tyrod Taylor, I think that's a player that exceeded expectations for most fans outside of Buffalo. That's step one. Step two, maybe even bigger. Is that the quarterback that the team should build around for the next few years?
Well, right now, as I look at it, without a doubt, he's got the arm strength. Of course, we all make mistakes out there, and he made some, you know, throws and decisions that, you know, you just don't make. But the thing is, it's his first year as a starter. You know, the only thing that will come out of it is he gets better. And I don't know a lot about that style of offense that that they've run, but with my mind right now trying to think of the system that they run. But, you know, more on the West Coast. And the thing is, I see what he can do. I see his running ability. I think everybody saw what he can do with his legs. But a lot of those happened to be when he was, you know, doing the seven-step drop. I said, hey, if you need to copy anybody's offense, look at what Tom Brady does with New England. He lived and died with that 3- and 5-step drop, and now I know he's paying the price because I think most of his offensive line is gone. But we need to get rid of the football at times a little quicker. But I think overall, I like what I've saw with Tyrod, and hopefully they can build on that going into next year.
You know, Jim, I hadn't been back to Buffalo since I played up there until this year. I've done a couple games up there for Westwood One. The stadium looks awesome. You know, the season tickets are up, the excitement. Everybody seems to be so pumped about how things are now that the Pegulas are in charge. Can you put it into words just how much they've meant to that team and that whole community?
That's unbelievable. I mean, as you saw with not only the excitement that Rex brought when he came here, but the Pegulas wanting to win. And they call it, Buffalo One, because we're always together. They own the Buffalo Sabres. They own the Buffalo Bills. And their dream and what they want in this city pretty much speaks volumes. And both of them are unbelievable. They're great people to be around. They're normal, you know, just like anybody else. They don't want to be in the spotlight. They want the people that are in that organization to make sure you run it like a pro, and Russ Brandon has done that. Now all we got to do is do it on the football field. These fans are, you know, so hungry for a playoff game. They're so hungry to move to the next level because it's been, I think, going on now 15 years and we haven't been to the playoffs. So in due time, hopefully that will turn around sooner than later because I'll tell you what, as I stated, and you know this, Ross, I mean, being up here, I mean, when you have made the playoffs that many years, you sell out every game. It just goes to show you what type of fans we do have here.
Jim, if the Pegula family, who you obviously have a fond feeling for, if they came to you and said, what's your number one recommendation personnel-wise? It could be first-round draft priority. It could be a free agent position we should target. It should be maybe it's a coaching move. What would be your number one want for next year's team?
Nice try. I'm still employed by the Buffalo Bills, so I will defer that to maybe another day. There's a lot of things I think you look at. And for me to point out just one, I think there are a few things they need to work on. I'm sure they know that too, but they definitely got to get better all the way around. They got to be more consistent. As far as individuals, you know, I can't point anybody out. I mean, these guys are out there doing their best, and unfortunately, it's a new system, both offensively and defensively, for both sides of the football, and it does take time. I mean, I don't know many coaches that have come in and automatically they've taken their team right to the Super Bowl. I mean, I'm sure there's exceptions to every rule, but, you know, we're just a little disappointed how everything went. We'll find out. As Rex said, I think last week in his press conference, there will be changes made. And I'm excited to see what changes he's planning on because it can't continue to be and play the way we have, and you got to get better, especially when we have the players that we have on our team. But the key for everything is our key players, our star players, to stay healthy. We can't afford to have Kyle Williams go down, Aaron Williams go down, and then Clay go down. And, of course, now we got McCoy, you know, he's down. He's been in and out throughout the course of the year. So, well, we just got to keep guys healthy.
You know, Jim, I really enjoyed watching the 30 for 30 on you guys, the four falls of Buffalo. Obviously, when I played there, they talked about you guys all the time, and a lot of you especially, still a really big presence there. What was your biggest takeaway from the 30 for 30? Did you think they did a good job with it?
I hate the title. Four falls of Buffalo. Okay, we know. We've had we kept giving up. How about something about resiliency and never giving up, something like that? But whatever. I thought it was a very, very good 30 for 30. I think that the part that I probably liked the most out of all of it is they highlighted a lot of Scott Norwood because the kid, you know, he doesn't deserve all the criticism he gets. And you know what? The thing is, he won so many games for us during the course of his career, and unfortunately, the one kick that meant the difference between us winning and losing, it went wide right and we lost. And I'm so glad that he got a chance to really, and having his coach, Bruce DeHaven, tell people how not only we viewed him as former teammates, but as his, you know, coach and the city of Buffalo, that, you know what, it's unfair, but you know what, that's part of sports. We all realize that. There's a lot of other people that, you know, one play can define their whole career, but unfortunately for Scott, that's the way it was. But I thought it did a good job of highlighting how we really feel and how much we really love Scott Norwood.
Jim, they say time heals all wounds. It's been over 20 seasons since those Super Bowls, over 20 years, a lot of time to sort through how you really feel about that time. When you watched Four Falls of Buffalo, is it still really painful, or has it been enough time where you watch that and smile and just feel good about the guys and what you accomplished?
You know what? A few years out. I mean, it's not as painful as it used to be. It brings, of course, it brings back memories and thinking, okay, what would have happened if we would have won 1, 2, 3, 4? You know, our legacy would definitely have been changed. But you know what? For me personally, maybe that's why, you know, when I did have a bad game, I would forget about it, come back, you know, and you know, play better. I'm very good at when negative things happen. Yeah, I think about it for a couple minutes, but then I refocus my attention somewhere else, more positive. And that's not just in my playing career. That's been my whole life. You know, from having a son after I retired, having a son born on my birthday, Valentine's Day, and then have him pass away. And how, okay, yeah, it's horrible. But what can we do to make it better? Not only for my son, but for others out there. And then, of course, my cancer battle. You know, yeah, I can sit there and feel sorry for myself or feel sorry I lost four Super Bowls or having a son born on my birthday or cancer. the ups and downs of my life. But the thing is, guys, I try to focus on the positive. How can I turn that negative into a positive? How can I make others feel better? How can I make people around me feel better? And I've been always very blessed that I surround myself with quality people, from family members to friends. I'm a very, very blessed man. And, yeah, I look back on there's some things I would love to change. But you know what? I am where I am. I am who I am. And that's how I was brought up by my father. And people always say to me, you know, what about your legacy? I said, I just hope I can make a difference, not only for the young, but for the old too, making sure that I make a difference in their life. And if it means continue to fight my battle with this or continue to stress for Hunter's Hope and what we're doing here, if it can make other people feel better and make their life better, then God bless them, and I'll keep fighting.
Hey, Jim, I kind of think Peyton Manning probably is going to try to play one more year if he doesn't play again this year. What would you say if he asked you for advice?
Well, to be honest with you, a couple weeks ago when I saw him, I'm like, man, I think it's time for him to retire. And then I saw the little video that they ran, the little pregame yesterday on him, and how quick he was moving with his footwork and how he threw the football. And I don't know. I mean, I'm not in his body. I just know when I retired, I couldn't lift my arm over my shoulder. I think that last game I sustained my fifth or sixth concussion. So for me, I knew it was time. And I wasn't one of those guys who was going to hang off for the money. I was a very blessed guy, and you know what? The good Lord gave me that amount of years at play, and I wasn't going to do it where I had, you know, somebody say, okay, time for you to hang up. You're no longer the starter. I like where I ended up. I just hope Peyton, in his heart and in his body, he'll know when it is time, and he's the only one that can do that or tell you.
Hey, Jim, anytime we can attach Hall of Fame quarterback to a guest, he's welcome on this show, but the kind of life you have lived and the experiences you've had since you've walked away from the field add a different layer of perspective. We appreciate your thoughts on the field and also weaving in those experiences you've had and speaking candidly with us this morning. So thanks for your time.
Oh, you're welcome, and I always enjoy coming on the show. You tell Dan I said hello, and God bless you all. Have a great new year for all of us. Hoping 2016 is better than 15.
All right. Hall of Fame quarterback Jim Kelly spending time with us here on the Dan Patrick Show.